Very good morning, students. Today I am back again with a new chapter of class 3 from English second book, and the name of the chapter is Just One Question. So students, this chapter has been presented in the form of an act. Before proceeding towards the chapter, let us know what is an act. An act is a part of a play defined by certain elements such as plot, character, and action, etc. So let's proceed towards the chapter. Just one question. There are five characters in the chapter: narrator, Emperor Akbar, Meghraj, Birbal, and courtiers. Courtiers were the attendant of Emperor Akbar's court. So let's proceed towards the chapter. Narrator. Emperor Akbar had an advisor named Birbal in his court. Birbal was famous for his smart thinking and clever answer. Emperor Akbar would often call on Birbal whenever he had a problem that he could not solve. So, Emperor Akbar had an advisor whose name was Birbal. He would often call Birbal whenever he had a problem which he could not solve. One day, a learned scholar named Meghraj came to Emperor Akbar's court. So, one day, a learned scholar, a well-educated man, came to Akbar's court to test about Birbal's wit. So, here comes Meghraj. Meghraj, oh Emperor Akbar, I have heard so much about your Birbal's wit. Here Meghraj asked to Emperor Akbar, Emperor Akbar, I have heard so much about your Birbal's wit, about Birbal's intelligence. Emperor Akbar, yes, Birbal is my trusted advisor. He has the answer to all my questions. Here Emperor Akbar says, yes, Birbal is my trusted advisor and he can answer all my questions. He can solve all the problem of Birbal. So here comes Meghraj. I do not believe that anyone can be so clever that he has answers to all questions. I would like to question him and witness his cleverness for myself. Here Meghraj said, I do not believe that anyone can be so clever that he has answers to all the questions. I want to test him. Who says? Meghraj. So, Emperor Akbar, certainly, I am confident that Birbal will answer any question you put to him. So, here Emperor Akbar says, why not? You can ask him any question. And I know he will be able to answer all the question. Narrator. So Birbal was summoned to the court. He came at once and bowed politely to his emperor. So after this, Birbal was called to the court, and when he entered the court, he paid regard to Emperor Akbar by bowing. So Birbal, your majesty, what can I do for you? So here Birbal asks, your majesty, what can I do for you? Emperor Akbar, Birbal, we have been honored by the visit of Meghraj, the learned scholar. He wishes to question you and see if you can answer. So here Emperor Akbar says, Birbal, a learned scholar has paid a visit to our court and he wants to ask you some question. Birbal, it will be my honor to answer his question. So here Birbal says, it will be my honor to answer his questions. Meghraj, well Birbal, would you answer 100 easy questions or just one difficult one? So here Meghraj gives option to Birbal. He said, Birbal, would you like to answer 100 easy question or one difficult one? Here Birbal, thinking hard, thinking again and again, sir, I would rather answer the difficult one since I have to be off on some important work and would not have the time to answer 100 question. So here Birbal says, sir, I would answer one difficult one because I have to be off because I have some other important work to do. So I will not have time to answer 100 questions. Narrator, Meghraj agreed at once. He had a question in his mind that no one had ever been able to answer. So Meghraj agreed that, okay, I will ask you only one question, one difficult question. And he had a question in his mind which no one had been able to answer. Meghraj, well then, answer this. Did the chicken come first or the egg? So here Meghraj asked a question. Did the chicken come first or the egg? Birbal, at once, the egg, sir. Birbal, how can you say that? Then when Birbal said the egg, sir, then Meghraj said, how can you say that? How can you say that egg come first? Egg came first. Birbal, sorry, sir. You said that you would ask just one question and you have already asked one. Now I must be off. So here Birbal said, sorry, sir, but you said that you will ask only one question and now you are asking me the next question. As Meghraj said that I will ask only one question. So the one question was over. Narrator, Meghraj was left speechless by Birbal's witty reply. He now knew why people called Birbal so clever. He was convinced of Birbal's wit and left Emperor Akbar's court happily. So, in the last paragraph, Meghraj came to know about Birbal's wit and he was convinced, he was satisfied with Birbal's wit and he left the court of Emperor Akbar happily. So students, I hope all of you have understood the chapter. Thank you.